While explaining to his guests what happened, Mbale City Town Clerk Ambrose Ocheng said it was the mercy of God that the victims are still alive at the moment. He added that the floods came with a lot of load that is very dirty and therefore there's likely to be an outbreak of cholera in a short period of time. Ocheng further explained that people have been affected psychologically and they don't sleep. He further reveals that the problem is so big that they are now worried how it will be should it rain again when the river has not yet been desilted.
The wall fence, all down.
Yes, we are now, in...
This is somewhere, somebody was sleeping the there. So you just imagine. But people survived. Now, the after effect. There was a lady I met there. She told me, the only clothes I have on me is this one I'm wearing. And that morning it was still drizzling. So the clothes she had on was wet. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
That is one. Two.
Terrible.
You have children who are looking at you. Mommy, food. The children were there. Five of them.
Everything is smashed.
No saucepan, no food, nothing to wear, nothing to sleep on. But you are there. Where to sleep was a problem. I am looking at our people going to be affected with the... We may have an epidemic here, diseases. Because remember, this thing came from up there down.
The head of delegation, Reste Chidabo, explained why they had taken the initiative of mobilizing the church towards this cause.
So we are here as Elmeni Ministry Department in SDA Church.
Okay.
And as mothers, we move with our daughters.
Okay.
So we have a sub-department called Young Women.
Okay.
And these girls are represented. Now, as mothers, when we saw what had happened, we felt so much touched, and we sat and like, what can we do? Because we know as mothers, we are the homemakers.
Speaking while receiving the relief, Mbale City RCC Ahmed Washaki attributed the flash floods to the activities of man against nature.
This is that disaster was a devastating one, but nobody knew that we would ever get such a disaster in the city. It goes all along. When it rains, we are looking at the Buddha, Sirocco, where by this time around, when it rained, for us, we were thinking of Buddha, Kumbe, it was just in our compound here. And it took lives. Over 30 people lost life here. This disaster here, the cause was the human cause. Because of our mishandling the environment in our area. And this one cuts across the whole country. So that's why the President of the Republic of Uganda and the government entirely is actually appealing to citizens to ensure we preserve the environment.
The flood victims explained what happened and how they survived.
The water was even up to there. So no vehicle would pass, neither border. All those people that attempted to pass, are the ones that fell in here and they died.
I don't know. I don't know.
Report by Wilfred Masaba for the news.